Coach Fechko, the Bulls of Buffalo are here, or the State University of New York at Buffalo?
Yep.
Okay, the Bulls, first off, I'm feeling a wave of success coming there. Coach Stutzman, he's a driven guy.
Very much so.
What's it like working with that guy?
Unbelievable. Passion is second to none. There's never a day that's the same as another. You know, it's always something new. But when he's created such an amazing culture and such an amazing environment that it's a lot of fun to work with him, work for him. And it's intense, but you know what? It's, like I said, his passion is second to none. It's a privilege to work with someone like that.
Yeah, I look at Nate Rose. I'll just go right off the bat. I'm not impressed with that. That guy's a stud.
Yeah.
Russell's for Trinidad and Tobago at the World Championships, wins a match,
mm-hmm.
and then, you know, can't let go of the leg in another match where he keeps getting in on shots at the world level.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at guys like that, you got young guys like that all peppered all through the lineup, studs. Mm-hmm. No competition for you guys last year postseason.
Right.
This year, MAC tournament, NCAA tournament. Mm-hmm. What's Stutzman saying to the guys?
You know, our expectations, he doesn't talk about winning and losing a whole lot. He talks about, you know, wrestling, training unbelievably hard, and then wrestling unbelievably hard. And then when you do those things, and living the right lifestyle off the mat, when you do those things all together, you give yourself the best chance to compete and perform at an extremely high level. And that's what we're looking for our guys to do.
Looking at, you know, Buffalo, it is not the easiest place to win because it's a really good school.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's hard to get some guys in. You know, let's be honest here. Some guys aren't great. They're not rocket scientists.
Right.
You know, you're not getting the guys in that you guys could get in at Bloom. It's different. It's a different culture, mm-hmm. as far as the college. It's one of the top research institutes in, you know, the country.
Mm-hmm.
But looking at that change, how have you guys been able to deal with that? Bring in smart kids who are also serious about wrestling.
I think it's a great selling point, actually, you know, because at the end of the day, you're going to get a phenomenal education, and that's important. Yeah, we want you to be a great wrestler, no doubt about it, but we want you to be a good person, and again, you're going to get a great education, and that's going to help you, you know, go get a job and, you know, throughout your life.
I said to Stutzman, I'm like, maybe Boomer's not the big name.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, he will outwork any coach in the country. Knowing, you know, you're a road warrior, man. You lived in California, coached high school wrestling. You lived in South Dakota, coached college wrestling. Bloomsburg, PA, Ohio. You went to college in Ohio. I mean, you are a road warrior when I look at it, a traveled guy. You know, what are you trying to get out there when you're here? Boomer Fechko, University of Buffalo. What do you want a kid to take away from this, knowing about you guys and the Buffalo Bulls?
You know, we're going to outwork people. You know, we're going to, as a staff, we're going to try and, you know, outwork everybody. And, you know, it's kind of what we expect our guys to do, too. You know, outwork them, you know, training, and then outwork them in a match as well. So I think, you know, overall as a staff and, you know, as a program, you know, there are certain things you can control and there are certain things you can't control. If you can't control it, you almost have to put it on the back burner. But if it's something you control, you got to try to do it better than anybody else. And that's, you know, that's the thing, is just work ethic. You know, grinding. You know, here, this is an unbelievable thing going on today. You're losing money if you're not here today. You know, you get to get a chance to watch kids train. You know, not just, you know, especially with recruiting, you see a lot of kids compete, you know, tournaments and matches. You don't get to see a lot of kids train, and this gives you a chance to watch them warm up, how they warm up, how they drill, stuff like that. And so this was an unbelievable event to come to. But, yeah, at the end of the day, you know, we want to be the hardest working guys.
So you're looking for hard workers is what you're telling me.
Hard workers.
And, you know, talent, obviously.
Absolutely.
Nate's got some talent.
Oh, yeah.
You need talented guys. You know, right now with the staff, you had a late Hassman goes to UNC. You and Grant bump up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, looking at that, you know, you're down a man essentially. If you're looking at coaching, you know, what is the silver lining with that? Do you think?
You know, Justin. Justin's going to be competing still, which is huge for the program. I think that's important. That, you know, have a guy who's still training, so he's working out the guys. You know, he'll be working out the guys all the time. And, you know, again, there's certain things you can control, and you know, Coach Hassman, it's great for him to go move on and do what he's doing. So you know, congrats to him on that. And this is a position we were put in. We have to find a way to, you know, continue to move forward. So you know, sometimes you know you get you know, cards dealt that are good and bad. Regardless of what they are, you have to find a way to continue to move forward as a program, and that's what we're trying to do.
Recruit kid walks up to you, you know, a senior, you know, rising or not even rising, a senior,
mm-hmm.
comes up to you. What do you tell him? What do you tell him about Buffalo?
Unbelievable place to be. You know, it's an unbelievable culture right now. You know, Coach Sussman's done a great job of turning that around and providing these kids with a great environment. And, you know, like I said, what we're looking for are guys who wrestle unbelievably hard, guys that train year-round, and guys that live the right lifestyle, because that's what our guys do now, and that's what we expect out of our guys. And so we want to find kids that fit the mold of our program.
All right. I know serious boomer coach, master's degree guy, graduate assistant coach of Buffalo. I also knew little kid boomer.
Yeah.
Can you still break dance?
No.
You can't?
No. You know, unfortunately, it's not like riding a bike where you can just pick it up and do it. No, I don't have it anymore.
You'd have like a broken wrist if you tried it right now.
I'd probably mess up.
It was amazing when you used to break dance. We'd always yell at you, can't.
Oh, I know.
But now you're serious grown-up boomer.
Let's go with that.
All right. Hey, thanks for the time. You got anything else for me?
Go Bulls.